And my next guest last year as a rookie led the majors with 53 home runs, and he was named the rookie of the year for that. Pete Alonso of the Mets is with us here. And Pete, thank you very much for taking the moment here. And
yeah, of course.
I just want to hear your reaction. You heard the commissioner there talking about how they will, whenever it is you guys were able to get back, try and get as many games in there to have as much of a representative regular season as possible. What do you think needs to be played this year for a regular season to feel meaningful?
Well, as much as possible. Right now we're in unprecedented times and we just want to play. I mean, it's very unfortunate right now. I mean, we're not the only industry being affected by this. I mean, I was thinking about this today. It's like for us ball players, we should be going to the yard excited right now. And there's plenty of other people out there in all different versions of the workforce that should be going about their normal Thursday, and they're not. And for us and many other people in this country, we're not working, and it's interesting. It's a very unique and unprecedented time, and we just want to play. We hope that everything just kind of, we just hope this virus goes away as quick as possible, because for us, we'll take what we can get, because we don't know how long this thing's going to run. So we just want this thing to end as quickly and as efficiently as possible, because at the end of the day, the boys want to play.
Yeah, and so let's talk about the baseball piece of it. Obviously, what you're talking about is considerably more important than anything else, but we all are sports fans here, and so the idea of coming back and possibly adding a lot of doubleheaders to the schedule. We had Mark Teixeira on earlier, and he expressed a lot of concern about that, particularly for pitchers. How would you see that if they were to try to add, let's say for the sake of argument, two doubleheaders a week, every week, in order to get in as many games as possible? What would be your thought on that?
Well, it's nothing that we didn't do in the minors, because rain delays or rainouts, like we had to play 2 7-inning games to make that up, and then hop on a 9-hour bus ride somewhere to another town. So, I mean, that's nothing that none of the guys haven't done before, because all of us have had to go through the minor leagues and go through that grind. I'd much rather hop on a flight somewhere after a doubleheader in the big leagues then hop on a 10-hour bus ride in the minor leagues. So I'm not opposed to it, and we've done it before, and I don't see why we can't do that.
That's a really interesting perspective that you may have here, because you know the baseball players, you guys were in spring training, you were in the facilities and they canceled everything, you were still in the facilities and they closed the facilities. I'm just curious, what kinds of conversations are you having with your teammates and the other players around the sport during this, as you pointed out, unprecedented time?
We just want to stay as ready as possible, because let's say if the government gets everything under control sooner than normal, then we're going to have to play and go to either spring training or our home cities and get ready as quick as possible. Because for us, we just have to, I know we have to stay home and be good citizens and practice the social distancing. But for us, it's like, it's, we can't just work at home. For us, we don't have a desk job. So it's going to be really tough to stay active, stay in baseball shape during this quarantine time. So, I mean, guys are staying as active as possible. So it's an interesting dynamic, because once we get the go ahead or the green light from the government, we're going to want to play, but also we're going to need time, or we're going to want to have or be as ready as possible. So because again, like if we just hit the start button too early, guys could get hurt. But I think that there could be some ways to kind of get around that regarding whether it be expanded rosters or stuff of that nature, or adding a DH or something like that, because now there's a 3-batter minimum, and I feel like the DH would protect health for a lot of the bullpen guys that have to face live pitching when they haven't in their career, or they haven't had to for the most part in their for a long while. So I mean, I think that there could be a lot of different ways where guys can, or like where both the teams and the players can find a middle ground and find some way to find the best way possible to protect guys. And at the end of the day, no one wants players hurt, because that doesn't help anybody.
Yeah, so we will all see what adjustments are made there. Quickly, anyone who follows you on social media has seen you've sent a variety of really heartfelt and really lovely messages to the nurses and the doctors who are on the front lines of this battle. What has inspired you to do that, Pete?
I mean, those people are working around the clock. I can't imagine what, like the security people at the hospitals, the nurses, the doctors, I can't imagine what they're going through right now with the amount of influx of people, because what they're doing right now is, I think it's incredible work, and to keep everybody safe and to treat the people who are infected or who are showing symptoms. I think those people are doing such a phenomenal job, because I mean, I don't think we've seen anything like this since 1918. And it's crazy how fast and rampant this disease has kind of infected and impacted the entire world. So what they're doing right now to prevent it, I think here in the U.S. we're really lucky, because we have some of the best medical staff in the entire world. So, I mean, if we're anywhere else, I feel lucky that that we're here, because those people are really busting it. So kudos to them, and thank you, not just for me, but I guess for all of us.
Pete, that's beautifully said. Thank you very much, my man, for doing this. We appreciate the time today. You stay well, and we will see you hopefully as soon as possible out there on the field. Thanks.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.